I look like a, serial killer. Hello! Hello and welcome back to another roundup of the week. This was really great last week. It actually went really well. I mean, it feels a bit weird to be like sat on my own in my house talking to myself. But I'm just imagining I'm talking to you guys. I mean, I think this is a really nice space for me to just connect with you guys properly. You know, how I actually react to stuff and how I feel about it, which is good, I think, for us. Let's have a look. Yeah, this is just reactions from you guys. We've got Rita Aura had a good laugh at me, which is good. I like making Rita laugh. Hi, Rita, if you are watching it again this week. It's quite cool. We've got Matilda Zenny. YouTuber Liam is what we didn't know we needed. We have no choice but to stan. Nice. Olivia underscore G12. I have a paper due in 30 minutes and I haven't started, but I will be watching this first. Well, I hope it was educational and informative for you and your paper. But yeah, thank you for all your reactions. Oh, so my sister had caught me out for not knowing who Flynn Rider was. I suppose I best educate myself at this point. Who is Flynn Rider? Is a fictional character who is in Walt Disney's Tangled. Haven't seen Tangled. Inspired by Han Solo and Indiana Jones. You know what? I'll take that.
Oh, all right, okay.
Oh, I'm watching a thing. Oh, hang on. Computer breakdown. I'm not sure what I can do, but we're gonna make it happen.
Time and job waste is not wasted time, so stay till the morning, stay for a while. I just wanna lay here, fall into midnight, and fall right into you.
2,000 years later.
Oh, yeah. This Tangle film. Hey, man. Well, I feel like I'm no closer to knowing the truth, really, whether he was a good guy or a bad guy. I mean, the other guys are, like, quite obvious Disney bad guys. I'm going to say he's a bad guy that turns into a good guy. So, I mean, I've actually always quite loved Disney. Disney's great. I actually found this week, my sister found rather, Nicola, my other sister, she found a drawing that I did when I was little. I don't actually remember doing this, but she had some sort of like 21st birthday quote. Look at that. I mean, I don't like the way she's looked after it, if I'm honest. It's fairly crumpled. That's an all right drawing right there. But that, I need to total how old I was. Right, so what else have I been up to this week? What have I been doing? I have done a lot of interviews and press, which you guys might have seen. I've been playing a lot of Fortnite, and I seem to be getting worse. Like, I definitely seem to be getting worse. I keep finding new things that I like about it. I've won a couple of times, but I feel like they were like sneaky victories where like I just jumped out of a bush and the guy happened to be like on half health and I just happened to win. Also this week, we had this picture. Now, I am at fault here because, but what happens is I'll get sent some sort of request like, can you take this picture or can you do this or can you do that? And sometimes I'm not really in the mood to want to take a picture. So I'll just do the picture. So I'm like ticking it off like my little checklist in my brain or whatever. And then this is the result we get. I honestly don't know what to say at this point. I keep feeding into the beast of people being able to look at my face and go, what is that? Was that a trick or a joke? I looked at the picture and for some reason in my head, I went, yeah, that's all right. That's okay, I just put that out there. Can't undo it now, the internet has it. I mean, more exciting news for you guys this week, I suppose. I've been making beats, been making stuff again. I've been making something with someone who's very unexpected, actually. Which I won't say too much about because I don't know what's happening with it yet, but we are working on something and you will never get, I'm gonna put like a contest out right now on this video and just see if anyone comes up with the person that it is, because you won't. I'm not even gonna give you any clues, you're just gonna have to guess. But they're not in music. But they are in music, but they're not, but they are, but they're not. Right, let's have a look at some favorite content that we've got for this week. That is hilarious. He's got his like arm up like, oh, I'm just chilling out here. It's like this, just chilling. looks up like, you called? Liam, what's the first thing you're going to do when quarantine is over? Love you so much, take care. From sweet Eroda. Everyone has really difficult, sweeter Eroda. Ah, see, everyone has really difficult names to understand. What am I going to do? I mean, obviously going to see my son would be my top priority. I'm on. What's going on? That was weird. Is that you making that noise? That little shoo. Do it go again? Are you using anything?
Yeah,
me. Do you? I heard a weird. We're watching like a creepy video, and then I heard something go on the side of my video. Weird. The thing went as well. Let's go back to this. I got distracted. Then I'm not even sure what's going on here. Get it? I get it now. I mean, just to get away from this for a minute. I mean, there's not the thing of like seeing a ghost or anything like that. But I am into like otherworldly ideas, let's say. I do like this sort of stuff. I love ghost adventures. I don't know if you've ever seen it. Good friends with Zach off Ghost Adventures. We went around his whole haunted museum thing together and it was a whole experience. I loved it. If you live in Vegas or are near Vegas when this is over, go and visit, it's really good. I have been experiencing a bunch of weird stuff within this house so far, with lights that are on, sensors coming on at random times, other things. And I was in bed the other night and there was a bang. And like, I tried to do like the whole like Ghost Adventures recording thing. This is what they do. I'm sat in my room going, is anybody there? Da, 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 da. Did you just make that knock? And then the wardrobe light in my room came on and the door of the wardrobe was closed. So something had to move. It was a freaky moment for sure. But I'm gonna do a video of something investigating to see if I find something. Because I think, I like this stuff. It scares the crap out of me, don't get me wrong, but it's fun. If you've seen something or you think you saw something, let me know, because I wanna watch. I might do like I should do a full thing of like scary things and you could see me just get scared out my my wits by stuff.
I just want to stay here and fall into midnight.
So I learned some Swedish this week too. I had a live chat with Alesso.
It's a win for me too. You know, I get to find, discover some, you know, potential
collab.
You sound
like some sort of like big New York business. It's a win for me too.
It's for me. It's a win.
Oh God, I hate watching myself, but this is quite funny. He is so funny. I love Alesso. Shop with our meatballs.
Shut
Buller. Teach me how to say
it's time to dance party.
No.
I'm gonna make a remix out of it later.
Didn't do it. Me and Alesso have got this week though coming up, we're doing this thing where we are playing a game of FIFA against each other, so be sure to tune into that so you can see who wins. It's gonna be me, so anyway. So yeah, you guys have been putting in your submissions for the fan remix, and I got to watch a few of them on the live.
I just wanna stay here and fall into midnight. I just wanna stay here and fall into midnight.
Well, she's got a very nice voice.
I just wanna stay here and fall into midnight. I just wanna stay here.
Everyone's so good. I think it's really good. Everyone's showing off amazing talent singing wise, like really, really great. I think the only thing I would say is make sure that you make it your own. Like, I want to hear like a really softly sang Billie Eilish-y style. Not like Billie Eilish now, but like, you know, the way that she like delivers like a word and like the way she says it, it's all like really tight. So a little bit like that. It was a terrible impression. Sorry, Billie Eilish, if I've offended you in any way. petition for Liam Payne to do a cooking with Liam segment on his new YouTube series. When I actually spoke to Gordon Ramsay, he said there's like a test that they do for chefs where he just gets them to make scrambled eggs, because it's like, you can tell a lot about a person by the way they make their eggs. So let's put ourselves through this Gordon Ramsay trial, and I'm gonna make you guys at home and myself some scrambled eggs in a moment.
12 seconds later.
Hello, welcome to cooking with me, I guess. We're gonna make some scrambled eggs. Now, I heard on the grapevine that Gordon Ramsay tests his chefs by how well they make their scrambled eggs. And some chives. Concentration is key. So make sure you don't chop your fingers. Okay, we've got some chives chopped up there. Then we wanna get some butter. I'm not sure whether you're supposed to use salted or unsalted, but I'm just going with it. I'm gonna put that butter in there. Oh yeah. It's going in there. Let's get the pan on the heat. Let's get cooking. All right, we're on. Melted butter, I'm melting the butter in. So we're looking for nice, creamy eggs. Like all good chefs have like a ham thing that they do, like Gordon does a little bit of this action. You know, we're looking for a creamy egg here, using, and then I feel like Jamie Oliver's always like, look at this, you know, the humble egg. What can we do with the egg? Okay, oh, we're frying the butter at this point, that's not good. Just take that off the heat a minute, let it cool down. Nice. We're gonna use 5 eggs. I can't do it with one hand, and I hope I don't get any shelling. Let's go. 1, 2, 3, 5. So yeah, if you can avoid getting shell in, it's always a good way to go. You want to look professional and stuff, but we're very real here at the Cooking Stuff Show. Okay, so now we're just gonna get them all nice and scrambled. Now we don't want to over stir, because it does something to the eggs, I think. It's science. Look it up, science. So we've got this sort of nice little golden consistency going on there. I like what I'm seeing. So we get them on the heat for a minute. Now the trick here is we're gonna keep them on the heat, and we're gonna take them off the heat. On the heat, off the heat, on the heat, off the heat. So we get this nice little cooking layer at the bottom. Let it heat. You don't put anything in the eggs until the very end. Bit cooked now. Little chill time here. You know, taking the view. It's like Bob Ross. It's like the cooking version of Bob Ross. You know, Gordon. I actually met Gordon in a nightclub, which was the one place that I wouldn't think we'd bump into each other, but he was in Vegas when the boxing match was on, the same time I was. We were in the club together. You know, when do you think you're gonna go clubbing with Gordon Ramsay? Never. But we did. He's a nice man. You know, most people get on with tidying up at this point as well, but I'm not that kind of chef. I like to pay close attention to what's going on in the pan. I can't talk this morning, apparently. See that there? It's getting nice and creamy. Light, fluffy eggs is what we're looking for. Light and fluffy. Light, fluffy, dynamic in flavour. So I'm ready for seasoning time. This is gonna make or break it. Make or break this little situation we've got going on in this pan. See there, that's coming in nice now. I mean, oh, look at what we've got going on in there. Just, you know, little light yellow clouds of heaven. We're not even on the pan, the heat's just going, you know what I mean? Helping the salt really season those bad boys up. A lot of people miss out on the seasoning. You've got to season well. A few turns of pepper. We're ready for a plate. We're ready for a plate. It's a plate. Done. That was eggs with me. Let's see how these taste. Oh, sublime, perfect. so that you can make that in 10 minutes. Someone at my door, so I'm going to go. See you in a bit.
Also this week, didn't really want to leave it out. Wanted to make sure I said something on my own place before I started getting asked about it relentlessly by everybody. I just wanted to say congratulations to Zane and Gigi. Obviously, you know, they're having a baby at the moment. So that was it. That's my show for this week. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Please keep commenting and subscribing and hit me with all your thoughts and ideas, and I will make sure that I try and squeeze as many in as I can. But yeah, let's just keep this going and keep this little connection going. It's nice. I'm enjoying it. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.